Hello, my name is Jimmy Costello from the NX product marketing team. Today, we're going to be looking into NX Immersive Engineering and how it can be used for modeling, visualization, and validation. NX Immersive Engineering is a visual experience that provides high-quality rendering and realistic definitions of geometry. Immersive isn't just a desktop experience. Using VR hardware can enhance your design experience even farther. However, significant value remains without the VR, so today we will enter the virtual environment without a headset. Here you can navigate around in full screen immersive to gain additional insights into your designs. We're going to investigate this automated bottle filling machine, specifically diving into movement and immersive, other desktop controls, and material change. As we get started, to find immersive, we need to navigate to the display tab. Once we've done that, the first thing we need to check is our immersive preferences. It's inside of here that we can select what device we're using with immersive, the display style, and the upwards vector. Additionally, it's also important to pay attention to the live updates and performance sections. If we want to make modeling updates to our part or assembly and see the changes in real time, live updates should be turned on. Merging components will improve the rendering speed for immersive. Only one of these two options can be selected at a time, so it's crucial to assess what is more important for your design needs. Moving along, we can now launch Immersive Explorer. When this happens, we get a new window with the automated bottle filling machine. It may seem confusing at first that there are no commands or tools to select on screen, but if we hit the H key from our keyboard, we will get a list of all the shortcuts we can use to navigate in Immersive. To move around, we can use either the arrows or W, A, S, and D keys. To go up or down, we can use the Q and E keys. The other important command to know when we're getting started is the Enter key. This will switch the setting behind your model. Continuing on, now that we understand the basics of movement, we can begin to dive into one of the most important modeling changes for immersive. Applying studio materials in NX will provide real-time updates in immersive. This makes it easy to explore new design alternatives and visualize end-of-production results. One added bonus to using these visual materials is we are able to investigate the textures on our assemblies as each material is added. This allows for immediate validation as new design changes are made. In conclusion, in this video, we explored the basics of getting started in immersive on desktop. We began by discussing preferences and assembly load options. After that, we discussed the movement settings and help guide for desktop controls. And finally, we wrap things up by investigating material changes and the impact they have on your immersive experience. I would like to thank you for your time and attention.